Bonjour à toutes, bonjour à tous, bienvenue dans le spot. La saison de trail est lancée et pour bien commencer aujourd'hui, on vous propose un portrait de la Suédoise Emilie Forsberg. Elle vient de sortir son premier livre, Vivre et courir, illustré par son compagnon Kylian Jornet. Je vous laisse découvrir le sommaire de l'émission. Trailleuse, skieuse et alpiniste, son palmarès n'a d'égal que son sourire. Emilie Forsberg, 31 ans, amoureuse de grands espaces et de plaisirs simples, elle sort son premier livre, Vivre et courir, illustré par un connaisseur en la matière, Kylian Jornet, son compagnon dans la vie et sur les sentiers. Avec ce livre, elle nous partage sa passion du trail au quotidien, bien au-delà des médailles et de la performance. Aujourd'hui dans le spot, rencontre avec la lumineuse trailleuse venue du Nord. Et pour commencer, les rendez-vous trail à ne pas manquer cet été, c'est tout de suite, c'est l'agenda. La Maxi Race revient une nouvelle fois sur les hauteurs du lac d'Annecy du 25 au 27 mai. Au programme cette année, des courses pour tous, petits et grands, un kilomètre vertical, un marathon ou encore un ultra trail. Le spot sera sur place pour vous faire vivre l'événement au plus près. Reste en Haute-Savoie avec le Marathon du Mont-Blanc du 28 juin au 1er juillet à Chamonix. Plusieurs courses au menu de cette nouvelle édition. Un marathon bien sûr, mais aussi un ultra de 90 km, un kilomètre vertical, des courses pour enfants ou encore des courses par équipe. Dans le Beaufortin, la Pierra Menta remet le couvert à Arèche-Beaufort les 6, 7 et 8 juillet. Venez vivre l'expérience version été. 3 étapes par équipe de 2 sur une distance totale de 70 km pour 7000 mètres de dénivelé positif. adepte de dénivelé, le Red Bull 400 revient pour la seconde fois consécutive sur le mythique tremplin olympique de Courchevel. Si 400 mètres ne paraît pas si long, parcourir cette distance en altitude sur une piste de saut à ski inclinée à 35 degrés est une autre histoire. Mêlant endurance et rapidité, le Red Bull 400 revient à Courchevel le 21 juillet.
Damn pain. Let the nighttime rain, driving you insane like a dog in the rain.
S'il vous reste de l'énergie, on enchaîne à La Plagne du 26 au 28 juillet avec la mythique 6000D. Un défi pour la plupart des trailers, un dénivelé positif de 3500 mètres pour un parcours total de 65 km. Un tracé qui emmène les coureurs du village d'Em dans la vallée au sommet du glacier de Bellecôte à 3047 mètres d'altitude. Vivez le trail en altitude. Pour la troisième année consécutive, la station la plus haute d'Europe, Val Thorens, organise les Valto Summit Games du 3 au 10 août. Trailers aguerris ou amateurs, en famille ou entre amis, bénévoles ou spectateurs, ce ne sont pas moins de 6 courses qui vous sont proposées. Que l'on participe ou que l'on encourage, l'ambiance est garantie du village jusqu'au sommet de Val Thorens. Et ça bouge dans la vallée d'à côté, enchaîné avec le Méribel Trail les 11 et 12 août. En plein cœur du massif de la Vanoise et du domaine des Trois-Vallées, le Méribel Trail se veut montagneux, technique, aérien et sauvage. Le rendez-vous idéal pour les amoureux de nature qui veulent découvrir le trail sur un petit parcours exigeant, mais aussi pour les trailers aguerris qui souhaitent se tester en condition afin de préparer les grands rendez-vous de fin de saison. Et en parlant de grands rendez-vous du 22 au 26 août, ne manquez pas l'UT4M à Grenoble, un festin du trail avec 12 formules de course au choix sur les massifs grenoblois, 10, 20, 40, 90 ou 160 km, il y en aura pour tous les goûts.
J'ai jamais autant cherché au fond de moi-même pour atteindre cet objectif qui est l'UTMB.
Et pour finir l'été en beauté, le Saint Graal du trail, l'UTMB, bien sûr, du 27 août au 2 septembre. Vivez le mythe, cette année Trek vous emmène au cœur de l'événement. Suivez en live la plus célèbre boucle autour du Mont Blanc et partez à la rencontre des figures emblématiques du trail dans un numéro exceptionnel du Spot à cette occasion.
Les gens nous ont acclamés, nous ont poussés tout le long, et c'était vraiment fabuleux.
À toi. L'année prochaine ou quoi?
My name is Emily Forsberg, and I am from Sweden. I have always been running, more or less. I just didn't compete until 8 years ago, and yeah, running and climbing and skiing has always been more or less a part of my life for many, many years now. And yeah, that's what I'm doing now. I did my first race 2009, and that was a pretty small Swedish mountain race. And I just signed up because many of my friends did it, and I loved running very, very much before I did it. And I was just curious to take it to a race, and it went really well. And I realized that, or I didn't realize I was good at it. I just realized that I did pretty well. And it was fun to try a race. To be a runner, but also a skier, and to do a lot of races, it demands a lot of planning, and to also have time for recovery and to do my projects that I like, and to have my small farm in Norway and to take care of that. So of course it is a lot of planning, and I'm very cautious. Like when I'm resting, I'm really resting, because that's the recovery is part of like managing to do everything as good as you can. And I just listen to my body a lot, because racing and training and traveling and having two seasons, it takes a lot of energy. So it's really important to listen to the body to not get burned out. Yeah, we live in Norway now, and actually I have been living many, many years in Norway. I did my university in the north of Norway, and then we tried a few years in Chamonix Valley, but I realized that I really missed wild mountains and like a bit more, just the freedom that the wild mountains give, and not to have ski lifts everywhere. And it was something that I really missed in my life, so we moved back to Norway.
I think I have a lot of dreams. And I think I'm pretty confident in that which way I'm going, I'm gonna be happy with that. My approach is very relaxed. Sometimes I can think about if I'm just too lazy, but the thing is, I'm in the winter, you just have some hours you can be outside without head torch, and some hours every day skiing, and then coming home drinking tons of hot chocolate with cinnamon buns, and you do you're following the season. That's fascinating. The 2 months of no sun, you don't realize how much you miss it. until you feel it again. To be a part of the nature, that's really important for me. I really just like to do what I feel like doing for the moment. When I think about it, I'm just feeling very, very lucky that I have the opportunity to do this. It's in summertime, you can just pack your running backpack with food and then you can be out for 80 hours if you want. You don't know what time it is, you're just going mountain and mountain. I still feel very new, even though I did 21 races last year. Almost all the races. What? I'm in the lead. How can this happen? Oh, I'm just keep running. We'll see how this works out. I don't train so much. I just move around.
Yeah, it's like, you know, I don't train, I just move, but still 20 hours a week.
It's okay. Not moving so much can be a small morning jog.
I grew up with a lot of people that told me that you should do what you love because that's the most important thing, and I think everything will be fine, you know? I really have a big trust in that. If you have a will and you know you have you see possibilities and you see directions, and you can just be confident in that, you know that you're going one way, and then you just go for that. I don't think everything is about running. Absolutely not, but it's a big ingredient. In 2 years I won't maybe remember a win or a good position, but to remember a good day out in the mountains, that's what I'm gonna remember.
I think for sure that I really appreciate, and right now I really need to live in a place like that, because I find myself in very balanced when I'm there, and like far away from big cities and like the business that a city creates, and I really, really feel very comfortable and at ease when I'm in our own small farm, and like it's very opposite from the racing life when you are in a competition and it's very, very busy and a lot of people, and that's really, that can give a lot of energy too, but for me the balance between those two, it's really important. The book's name in English, it's Skyrunner, but in French it's Vivre à courir. And I really like the French name actually, and if I in Swedish, it would be a perfect translation, actually, because the book is, it's about life much more than just running every step. But as life is so much about running for me, it's about a lot of running too, but a lot of different aspects of running and like what makes running so complete, I think. I want to transmit like the happiness that running can give you if you take away all like, okay, running should be this and I should feel like this and I should do a time like this. I want to share the joy that I have found through the running and how much it gives me, and how much it gives me just not only running but when I'm doing other things because I am running, and how I feel when I run and why I feel, and like all the steps that running has given to me. And I wanted to transmit that and to share it, and to write the book. It's a big step to write a book, but I have always liked to share things that I really like or things that I think makes everyday life something special. And I actually started my own blog like many, many years ago, and it was maybe my friends who read it. And then the blog became a blog at a big newspaper in Sweden, and then it became an article in newspapers. So the step to write has like increased, and it was a really good challenge to just take it to write a book. Yeah, it has been amazing to work with Kilian as a photographer, because first of all, he's a really good photographer, and it has been so nice to see him year after year putting much more interesting and getting more knowledge. And to work with him as we share a life together, it's so much easier, and all the pictures becomes very authentic. And all the running pictures, I don't need to stop and repeat like you need to do on a normal photo shooting. It has just been like, I run and it's like, that's what I do. It's authentic, and Kilian just has been taking the pictures during the time and like running faster or, yeah. So it has been amazing, very easy to work with him. I find writing very challenging, and I find it very creative. But I don't feel like writing another book right now. I have another project which is a bit more cooking, and like a bit more. I cannot talk too much about it, but it's less writing, but more practical. So right now I have kind of finished my ski season, at least the bigger races, and I transitioning now to running, and I take it gradually. So my first race will be in end of May in Spain, and then it will continue with races during the summer and hopefully Germany marathon and some races around.
D'Emilie, Vivre et courir est d'ores et déjà disponible. Un grand merci à elle de nous avoir accordé un peu de temps. Merci à vous tous de nous avoir suivis. Très bonne soirée sur Trek. À la semaine prochaine dans le Spot.